Hi, and welcome to your water treatment plant. My name is Krista, and I'm going to be showing you around. Let's go! Today we're going to have a look around and find out how water is collected from a natural source and made safe for us to drink. I know all about smart water starts with you, and I hope you learn more about that too, and start to think about how water is an amazing resource that we have to look after. Here in the Waikato, each person uses around 250 litres every day. That's this many milk bottles.
Look around your group. Can you guess how many bottles of water you would all use each day? Now imagine how much water your whole school uses, how much your town uses. Water starts to be a very big deal. Water is a limited resource that we often take for granted here in New Zealand. You turn on the tap and clean, healthy water comes out every time. Because we're so used to water on tap, we often don't think about water as a valuable resource that needs treatment before it's safe to drink and use. In Waipa District, there are also lots of different sources. Te Awamutu and Parongia get their water from Mangaweka Stream on Mount Parongia. Kihikihi uses two bores in the centre of the town that tap into the Waikato local aquifer. Cambridge and the surrounding rural properties get water from just above the Karapiro Dam. Two separate springs from the lower slopes of Mount Maungatauriri and from an intake on the Waikato River, just below Cambridge. Ōhaupō Township, the airport, and the rural area around Pukeremu is also supplied from the Waikato River, but from another intake below the Karapiro Dam, downstream of Cambridge. Some of you might get our water from a different source. Some people collect water from the roof of their houses and store it in tanks. Some families use a pump system in a stream to transport water to their house. It's quite common for farms and rural properties to use an underground bore or well to get water from. Most of us are connected to the piped network provided by your local council. That's the system we are going to learn more about today. We're going to check out the process that water takes from the source and makes it ready for us to drink.
This is where the water is taken from the river. It's called the intake.
The water comes through the metal grates. Their job is to stop large items like logs, branches, and rubbish from getting in with the water and wrecking the treatment plant's machinery. This is the first part of screening. The water flows from here to the pump house. The water from the intake goes through a band screen next. The water is pushed through the vertical band screens that are 20 metres tall. The band screen takes out river weed, twigs, leaves, and other small items. All that stuff is collected at the top and washed right back into the river. This is one of the ways to minimise our impact on the water source.
After the water has been screened two times, it comes into the water treatment plant. Come see.
Large pumps move the water from the intake into the water treatment plant in these pipes.
This is what the water looks like at this point. It's not quite ready for drinking at this stage. It still needs to have all the little microscopic bits taken out. That's what happens here at the sedimentation tanks.
The first part of the process is called sedimentation. That means letting all the tiny bits of dirt fall to the bottom. But some of them don't want to do that. They are too small and stay suspended in the water. So to help get them to settle out, we add two chemicals called aluminium sulfate and polymer. Aluminium works by breaking weak bonds that hold small bits of dirt in suspension. The polymer also helps small suspended bits to clump together to form bigger, heavier particles called flocculant or flock. The water then comes to these hopper tanks. These are shaped like a V, pointy at the bottom. The flock in this tank looks like a murky, woolly blanket. You can see it floating in the tank. The water comes into this tank from the bottom. So as the water rises through the blanket, more flock joins the blanket. This is a way to filter the water. This flock is sucked out of the tanks all the time and goes into the wastewater system. The water treatment plant operators can tell a lot about the quality of the water by looking at the flock, what colour it is, how tight it is formed, and how the blanket looks. This helps them make sure the water treatment plant is operating well. These hopper tanks and the flock blanket have removed nearly all of the small tiny bits of dirt. The next stage filters out the rest. These are the gravity-fed sand filters, which means the water comes in the top of the pool and slowly passes through the sand filters at the bottom. The sand filters get cleaned every 70 to 100 hours. It's cleaned by blasting air through the sand filters, followed by clean water to wash out the dirt. The sand filters take out any flock that's left and also gets the larger microorganisms found in the river water. The main organisms are crypto and giardia. Both these microorganisms can make you sick, so it's best to get rid of these.
This water looks pretty good. We now know that it's been screened a couple of times, had chemicals added to remove all the dirt, and filtered out the large microscopic bugs. What else could be in there? This is the granular activated carbon room. Granular activated carbon is this stuff here. Have you ever had a tropical fish and used this in the filter?
How it works is the granular activated carbon has a huge surface area, with each grain of carbon covered with tiny gaps and holes. This helps the carbon to absorb any particles not able to be removed in earlier steps of the treatment process we have seen. It helps if there are taste and smell problems caused by algal blooms in the water source.
These tanks have heaps of these cone-shaped filters that let the water pass through,
but trap the tiny carbon particles so that they stay in the tank and keep working.
Man, I've been walking all over this water treatment plant. Where can I get a drink around here? Surely the water's clean by now. We've dealt with the larger microorganisms, but are there any microorganisms?
This is the UV area. These are here to zap any remaining microorganisms, even protozoa, which are single-celled microscopic organisms. The UV light deactivates these organisms by permanently altering their DNA structure, so they are unable to infect or reproduce. Water is passed through these large cylinders, which are filled with heaps of these UV tubes.
And that's where the zapping happens.
Just before it heads off to your house, the water needs some chlorine to kill any remaining bacteria and viruses that have escaped all our other screens, filters, chemicals, and UV traps. There's a large tank where all the water waits for an hour to maximize the effect of the chlorine. A small amount of chlorine is left in the water, leaving the treatment plant to provide some protection in the pipes, so the water remains safe between leaving the plant and coming out of your tap.
Now that you know the process that it takes to get clean water to your tap, would you agree that it's a valuable resource? Can you think of ways to reuse water at home? The easiest way you can take action is by sharing what you've learnt today with your family and friends. We all need to work together to be smart with our water. Smart water starts with you.